the ocean, a breeding ground of life, home to a vast number of species, barely researched even to this day. Here, hundreds of millions of years ago, the very first life forms came into existence. Simple unicellular life evolved into a complex biodiversity. Born in the ocean, life conquered water, land, and air. Let's discover the world of the coral reefs, where we meet some of the most ancient existing life forms. Then, we'll follow evolution as it makes its long way from the depths of the ocean onto the land. In its unique play of colors, the biodiversity mirrors life's ability to transform. Even today, the colors of evolution don't seem to know any limits. Once life had formed in the ocean, evolution took its next crucial step. The creatures of the sea moved out onto the coast, where they developed lungs. Now, for the very first time, they were able to explore the lands of Earth. For some of them, even the sky wasn't the limit. They were given wings and conquered the sky as they ascended to mind-boggling heights. With the formation of complex life, even the face of our planet underwent a major transformation. The Earth now blazed with the blue and green tones of a new era, while pulsating with the energy of inexhaustible life, to which it now was home. Even nowadays, as we observe our planet from the sky, we feel its boundless energy, as we're astonished by its unique beauty. Be it its majestic mountainsides, its green forests, or its ever-flowing rivers, our planet's beauty knows no limits. Water, cornerstone of life. It was the oceans that gave birth to the first microorganisms and thereby laid evolution's foundation. About 70% of Earth's surface is covered with water, just like our bodies consist of 70% water. This comparison makes us aware of the inseparable connection between our planet and ourselves. It shows us that the water of our Earth is the elixir of the life it brought up. Even today, the ocean is home to innumerable life forms, most of which still remain hidden from the human eye. Some planets in our solar system have been researched in much more detail than the oceans of our Earth. Having always been a crucial part of natural philosophy throughout the history of mankind, the earliest philosophers already declared water to be the prime matter of existence and one of the four main elements of Earth. These tree corals are just one example of the diverse shapes and colors of different coral colonies. Believe it or not, these tree-shaped corals are colonies of animals that consist of many individual polyps that grow out in branches. The leathery coral grabs our attention with her unique shapes. Here, you can see the real extent of evolution's creativity. Leathery corals can grow in the shape of trees, fingers, or crusts, depending on their environment's conditions. In most cases, the leathery coral shimmers in colors of yellow or brown against the ocean's blue in the background. We meet the architect of enormous underwater constructions, the stony coral. They belong to the family of sessile animals, which means they settle down in one spot and make it their permanent residence for the rest of their lives. Stony corals have the ability to secrete lime, which, over a very long period of time, leads to the formation of coral reefs. In this way, gigantic coral reefs are formed over the course of thousands of years. The most impressive example is the Great Barrier Reef, found on the east coast of Australia. Its surface covers an area of roughly the size of all of Germany, which makes the Great Barrier Reef the biggest construction ever built by life forms. You can find stony corals in the tropical zones of the ocean, where the water temperature consistently remains between 20 degrees Celsius and 29 degrees Celsius. This coral species can transform into various shapes by separating their polyps or growing on new coral discs. They resemble brains, tongues, or mushrooms. A sea fan is protruding from the frame while presenting itself in its typical green color. They can be seen in every one of the Earth's oceans. They can grow in different spots, be it deep down in the sea or up high in the shallow waters near the coast. The sea anemone is a great home to fish since it's a safe hiding spot. It shows us the importance of corals to life in the reef. The fusiliers swim in the Indo-Pacific Ocean and live among its corals. During the night, the corals offer them a safe place to hide. The coral reef is an exhibition of Earth's various life forms, and there are creatures of all sizes to be seen. We spot the little glassy fish darting between the stony corals, as well as the astonishing giant clam, an animal that can grow up to 1.4 meters and can become as heavy as 400 kilograms. Corals offer a great hiding place for young ones as well, such as the offspring of these white-tailed damselfish. They have to defend their breed from predators for up to 4 weeks after they're born. But the corals themselves also benefit from their inhabitants. Many fish that made a coral their domestic hiding place protect it from assailants who see them as a delicious meal. This effort is the rent a fish will pay in order to call a coral its home. This colorful fella is a parrotfish. Its name comes from its unique appearance, much resembling the bird. But don't let its appearance fool you. Despite his enchanting looks, the parrotfish is a pest to the coral reef. Using its beak-like teeth, the parrotfish grazes the low vegetation cover and thereby contributes to the reef's natural erosion. Unremarkably, the sea cucumber drags itself across the bottom of the sea. But the sea cucumber is not as lazy as it might seem. Sea cucumbers make up a stunning 90% of the near-ground biomass. These tiny vacuum cleaners can be found in all the seas of our Earth. Coral reefs pulsate with life. This exotic habitat presents itself with a colorful diversity of species that can't be found anywhere else in our world's oceans. After the tropical rainforests of Africa and South America, the Great Barrier Reef houses the highest biodiversity on our planet. With almost every dive, a new species that settled over the course of evolution is discovered in the reef. And every single one of its inhabitants developed their very own strategy to secure their survival. It's the fish with their various sizes, forms, and colors that make us feel as if we just arrived in a strange, magical world. Suddenly, we encounter a swarm of grunts. Throughout the day, they crowd at the reef's bottom, where they have the best hiding spot, and make up a blue-gray wall. Even at night, when they become active, they move in a swarm as they hunt for invertebrates. Their name comes from the characteristic grunting sounds they produce using their pharyngeal teeth. This grunting sound is amplified by their swim bladder. When they're young, grunts prefer to inhabit the reef as loners. It's only with time that they develop into swarm fish and begin living in stunningly large pods. Another swarm fish we meet on our expedition is the two-bar sea bream. We recognize it by the two black stripes running across its head. Sea breams are hermaphrodites. They either have both male and female reproductive organs, or they change their gender throughout their lives. Sea breams are open to all diets. They make use of the reef's rich supplies in different ways. They can live as either herbivores or carnivores. Their teeth then develop depending on their preferred nutrition. By assembling in medium-sized swarms, they can swim above the reef with great speed and follow small boats in order to gather sinking leftover food. When they don't escort smaller boats, these elegant inhabitants feed primarily on algae. Throughout our dive, we meet all kinds of swarms that either take a rest at the safe and comfortable spots in the reef or roam their habitat in their daily patrol. The swarm formation is one of the most impressive survival strategies evolution's toolbox has to offer. By assembling in a large, uniform mass, the probability of being caught sinks for every single fish in the swarm. Of course, the search for food is much easier with many pairs of eyes. Mating also becomes less difficult, since it's much more likely to meet a partner in a large swarm. Yet, other species of fish have developed into true lone fighters. They roam the reef as loners and have perfectly adjusted to the reef's conditions in their very own way. By swimming on their own, they can dodge an attack by hiding in caves or in between corals. Nutrition is another critical factor. For fish that consume their diet in small portions or by traveling long distances, it is advantageous not having to share their meal. All together or on their own, the reef's inhabitants developed many different strategies of survival. They owe their very existence to the reef, and therefore live in harmony with their habitat. While some of them developed into omnivores that eat both meat and plants, other inhabitants of the reef have specialized in food other species can't make any use of. Diurnal fish, or fish active during the day, are often of blue color. That way, they're hard to spot in the open sea at daytime. Nocturnal fish, their counterparts, often have a red coloring. Other color patterns and characteristics can function as a disguise, a beacon, or a warning signal. The color also reveals one's species, which helps with the search for a mating partner. Some youngsters have developed an especially cunning trick. As juveniles, they take on a strange color pattern, which is ignored by predators. This way, they can safely reach adulthood. No, that's not seagrass calmly rocking in the stream. What we see here is a trumpet fish. By positioning itself vertically or diagonally, the trumpet fish lurks on its prey before coming to life and catching its prey. Also swimming horizontally, and just as stiffly, the silver glittering barracudas shimmer in the water. In their appearance, they closely resemble pike. Stark eyes protrude from a tiny head, while the lower jaw surmounts the upper jaw, indicating a dark mouth. Depending on their kind, barracudas can grow to sizes of up to 2 meters long, turning them into dangerous predators. The harlequin sweet lip might be much smaller than a barracuda, but its color patterns are much more splendid. It can grow to up to 1 meter in size and stands out with its distinctive pattern, which resembles that of a leopard. Its name comes from its characteristic overblown lips. Throughout the day, this fish hides in the safety of the corals while resting in overhangs and caves. At night, the harlequin sweetlips becomes active as it hunts for invertebrates inhabiting the seafloor. With its typical wriggling movements, this harlequin sweetlips guides us through the reef like a tour guide, introducing us to its fascinating world. Throughout our trip along evolution's ladder, we meet a creature that forms a connection between life on the land and underwater, the sea turtle. The green sea turtle spends a great part of its life in the sea. However, the females dare to leave their trusted habitat once in their life, during breeding time. With slow, heavy steps, the female turtles move out onto the land in order to lay their eggs. Just one clutch can sometimes consist of up to 100 eggs. Green sea turtles hatch on shore. At the beach, they see the light of day. Then, they dash towards the water to dive in. The turtles only come to the surface to draw breath. One load of air can supply them for such a long time that they can spend hours sleeping in the reef. Green sea turtles were observed as they returned to the same sleeping place in the reef, night after night. Just like in a horror movie, long, feeler-like antennae protrude from a cave in the coral reef. They belong to a langoust, a species that uses its antennae primarily as a tactile organ, or simply, as eyes. Incredible but true, the pair of antennae can be larger than the ambusher's actual body. We meet another cave inhabitant that stares at us from his hiding place with watchful eyes, a green moray. Throughout the day, they just want to be left alone as they hide in the crevices and caves of the coral reef, where they can easily become a calamity to unwary divers. Their strong bite can quickly cost a human his finger or even an entire hand. Their ancestors already populated the seas about 400 million years ago, when our Earth was still another. They experienced the transitions of the oceans over millions of years firsthand. These true miracles of evolution fascinate us even today. Sharks. Their streamlined body structure, in combination with their smooth, scaly skin, reduces the water resistance to a minimum. That's why sharks are one of the fastest and most elegant swimmers of the sea. Sharks adapted themselves perfectly to life underwater. Their eyes are extremely light sensitive in order to spot the fast movements of their prey. Their excellent sense of smell makes it possible to sense one drop of blood in a million drops of seawater. This sense of smell is so distinct that even a blind shark can catch his prey with ease. The largest shark, and at the same time the largest living fish today, is the whale shark. The longest individual ever measured was almost 14 meters long, but it's said that some whale sharks that were spotted were up to 20 meters in length. Their most characteristic feature is the large mouth that extends across the entire width of their flat snout. Inside, one can find about 3,600 tiny teeth in 300 tightly arranged rows. With their mouth, whale sharks actively soak in the water. This way, they can soak up to 6,000 liters. Then, they press it out through their large gills. In order to satisfy their enormous need for food, they use this technique to filter plankton, as well as small fish and other species from the water. The humpbacks, that can even be spotted from the air due to their incredible size, are very popular among whale watchers because they love to impressively emerge from the water or smack their fin onto the ocean's surface in spectacular grace. These true giants are constantly traveling. Their summer quarters are located in the polar oceans, while they spend their winter in tropical and subtropical waters. When commuting between his summer and winter domicile, the humpback travels thousands of kilometers each year. With its average length of about 13 meters, the humpback is a rather small member of its kind. But what the humpback lacks in size, it makes up with its agility and liveliness. While the humpback's summer quarters are always located in close distance to the shore, they can often be met at the surface, as their dives only go on for about 15 minutes. When they rise to the surface in order to replenish their air supply, they form their characteristic hump and let their fin protrude from the water before diving back down. A particularly energetic humpback will even emerge from the water with a powerful spin, thereby completing an acrobatic jump. Normally, humpbacks travel alone. Only for hunting or mating do they occasionally swim in small groups of 2 to 9 individuals. At the feeding grounds in summer, as well as in the mating areas in winter, humpbacks sometimes assemble in larger groups in which they communicate through an enchanting singing. Every individual has their own unique song by which they can be identified. A whale song consists of multiple recurring verses that can continue for up to 30 minutes. A humpback fin is also unique to every single individual. Every humpback has a different black and white drawing on their wavy trailing edge. Because they let their fin protrude from the surface, scientists worldwide are able to name, follow, and understand the roots of single humpbacks. Ever since the 17th century, whales were hunted by humans for industrial purposes, until the whale population only consisted of a few thousand individuals in the 1960s. The humpback found itself close to extinction. The reaction came in 1966 with a total worldwide ban on humpback whaling. And it worked. Today, we can still study and marvel at these incredible creatures. However, although whaling no longer comes as a threat to humpbacks, industrial fishing nets, collisions with ships, and strong noise disturbances still aggravate their lives to a great extent. But once they can freely and effortlessly swim through the seas, they beam with a remarkable liveliness and joy. After rotating beneath the water's surface, they re-emerge and make shimmering rainbows with their blow. A characteristic feature of humpbacks are their enormous pectoral fins, which can reach up to one-third of their body's size. They can become much larger than the pectoral fins of other whale species. The skin of the humpback is covered in bumps and gashes to which barnacles can attach themselves. Humpbacks can be met in all of our Earth's oceans. Most of the time, they stay near the coast. Humpbacks never pass the equator. This means that independent populations live in the northern and southern hemisphere. Only in their behavioral patterns are the humpbacks similar all over the world. In summer, they stay in polar regions and hunt alone or in groups in order to accumulate fat reserves. During the winter, humpbacks can be found in warmer regions where they feed on the fat reserves and make use of the peaceful time for mating. We are being watched by a group of attentive observers from a rocky plateau. California sea lions don't crawl, although that's what most people think. Instead, they can skillfully turn their back fins underneath their body and use their lateral fins as supporting elbows. This enables them to move on all fours. This way, they have an advantage over their fellow species members, as they can move on land in a much more agile and efficient manner. Among the seals, California sea lions are considered to be particularly fast and elegant. In the water, they can reach maximum speeds of up to 40 kilometers per hour. Unlike other kinds of seals, the males don't have a mane. They can reach up to 2.2 meters in size and weights of up to 400 kilograms, while females can only reach lengths of up to 1.8 meters and weights of up to 90 kilograms. Seals catch their prey in depths of up to 40 meters, while always keeping as close to the shore as possible. Among their prey are fish and squids, which are often hunted down and encircled in groups. Groups of seals were even observed as they went hunting larger swarms of fish alongside dolphins, porpoises, and seabirds. On the rocky plateaus, Males fight for the best mating places inside the colony. A harem of around 16 females emerges around the winter. However, this number of females varies depending on the territory. The offspring is cared for intensively and given breast milk for a week after birth. Seals can weigh up to 6 kilograms at birth already. Inside the colonies, seals live tightly packed with one another. Often they have no more living space than just 1 square meter on the plateau. Should a seal ever be uncomfortable while trying to sleep, however, it's not a problem. Seals are able to sleep in the water. In order to do so, they let themselves float on the surface. A picture straight from a travel magazine. The human tends to have a very special relationship with the California sea lion. Since these creatures are very peaceful and show close to no aggressive behavior, they're the easiest to tame among their fellow species of seals. For seal shows and performances in zoos and circuses, the gifted performers will always be California sea lions. The fact that they can be tamed and follow commands reveals yet another characteristic of theirs. California sea lions are highly intelligent creatures. Even among themselves, communication is very important. Born on land and underwater, the sea lions communicate using different barking sounds. Mothers and their children even have their very own barking communication. Throughout the last centuries, the California sea lion was hunted for its skin and oil. In the beginning of the 20th century, the numbers of sea lions had dropped to a critical minimum. The orca and larger sharks are also predators hunting sea lions. And as they float on the water's surface, sea lions make an easy prey. In present day, the numbers of sea lions have replenished themselves to a good amount. Although the California sea lion mostly inhabits the coasts of California and northern Mexico, it travels over long distances during mating time and can therefore be found all the way up to the western Canadian coasts. The California sea lion can spend 2 weeks continuously in the water. In that time, he can feed on his fatty tissue and float on the water's surface to sleep. Long travels by water are usually by males, though, as they look for new hunting grounds outside the mating period. Some sea lions travel in groups, while others prefer traveling alone. But as the sea lions leave for their long-distance swims, they have only one aim: to collect as many fat reserves as possible in order to defend their space on the plateau during the upcoming mating season. After swarming out and successfully completing a hunt, the California sea lions once again gather at their rocky plateaus, closely packed one to another. The transition from water to land is done by the coast. The coast is a ladder that enabled countless life forms to ascend onto the land and take the next evolutionary step. Even after millions of years and the enormous progress of evolution, the coast remains a fascinating habitat. Coasts are just as diverse as life on Earth. Depending on form and shape, there are different types of coasts to be found. Flat coasts, where the land only gradually transitions into the sea, can reach up to 100 kilometers into the land's interior. The coasts experience constant change. Their form and location are constantly under the influence of various factors, such as changes in the current conditions and the sea level. But they are also influenced by the human. 3/4 of all cities on Earth with a population of over 10 million are located in coastal regions. At high coasts, the land lies high above sea level. Most high coasts are cliff coasts, which were formed by a landslide or rockfall following the constant erosion of landmass. This way, the characteristic rough cliff could form. Cliff coasts are divided into living coasts and dead coasts. Dead coasts have stopped undergoing any change, as they're only reached by exceptionally high waves, and can therefore hardly experience any erosion. On the other side, living cliffs still experience erosion, and depending on their location, will still be exposed to the sea's waves for thousands of years. As we leave the sea and slowly move towards the land, we meet one of evolution's most remarkable children, birds. As it emerged from the water, life didn't only conquer the land, but the air as well. Over millions of years, their ancestors developed a relatively soft fluff that evolved into large wing feathers and opened up the skies. One of the most passionate flyers on our Earth is the white stork. What sets him apart from the rest of his species is his ability to travel over 20 kilometers across the land. Storks have now existed for about 30 million years. Depending on their kind, they can reach sizes between 75 centimeters and 150 centimeters. They are among the birds with the largest wingspan, with an impressive 3.2 meters. The long beak most likely developed to give the stork an advantage over its rivals in the search for food. It's a marvelous sight when storks ascend into the skies in their famous V formation. Now that we've reached the land, we're presented with an inexhaustible diversity of species, brought up by evolution over many years. In its amazing forms and colors, life on land is in no way inferior to that in the oceans. In the wide steppe of the African Serengeti, we meet a variety of ungulates, most likely on migration. Among them are the popular zebras, relatives of the horse, as well as the wildebeest that are summed up as antelopes, just like many other species. They live in small herds, most of which consist of one male and 8 females with their offspring. The other males are abandoned by their herd at a certain age and gather in groups of youngsters. Once they reach the age of 4, they can lead a herd by themselves and protect it against intruders. Rivalries between males are often decided through threatening gestures. Only in rare cases does it come to actual confrontations, where their horns come into use. Zebras are known for their characteristic black and white stripes. This is a disguise enhanced by the shimmering air of the hot African savannas. When they gather in herds, individuals are no longer clearly visible, which makes it hard for predators to attack. It's also a protection against tsetse flies and horse flies, which transmit the infamous sleeping sickness. Due to their compound eyes, the flying bloodsuckers cannot identify the black and white coloring. Different groups of antelopes also roam the Serengeti, always on the lookout for the next watering hole. They're scattered in herds and groups, in which they trot across the wide, lush grasslands and dry semi-deserts. The tallest creature to be found on land is the giraffe. Male giraffes can protrude up to 6 meters into the air and weigh around 1,600 kilograms. Their mighty necks let them look at Earth from a viewpoint withheld from other species. The 2.5-meter-long neck is most likely a way of showing dominance in fights between two males. But the long, attractive necks are also a great way of gaining a female giraffe's attention. Giraffes also live in smaller herds, but in contrast to other species, their bonds are much less tight. Here is another competitor for the title of largest animal on Earth, the elephant. Depending on its kind, elephants can grow up to 4 meters and reach a weight of up to 5 tons. The agile trunk is a multifunctional tool. With its help, the elephant can smell, breathe, feel, grab, and drink. The trunk consists of around 40,000 bundled muscles and doesn't have a skeleton. This way, the trunk gains an enormous elasticity and agility, which enables the elephant to grab food up to 7 meters above ground. Because of its weight, the elephant has to consume up to 200 kilograms of food per day. This consists of grass, fruit, branches, twigs, and tree bark. Their numbers shrunk throughout the last decades, since elephants were increasingly forced out of their habitat and actively hunted, despite a total ban. Should this continue, these majestic creatures could, just like their ancestor, the mammoth, vanish from the face of the earth. The consumption of water is an important factor in Africa's hot climate, and small, open watering holes are a great place to roll around. Such a mud bath gives a refreshing chill. But the mud also protects from insects and helps with healing open wounds. The cheetah is one of the deadliest predators of the African savanna. As it's able to reach speeds of up to 90 kilometers per hour, the cheetah is considered the fastest land animal on Earth. But a cheetah can't keep his maximum speed for long, since his muscles overheat, just like a machine working at full blast. The cheetah uses these speeds primarily on the hunt. The predator stalks its prey until it's very close, before launching itself underneath the animal's legs. Once the overwhelmed animal hits the ground, there's no escape. Among predators hunting on their own, the cheetah achieves the highest success rate. Therefore, it's not surprising that cheetahs were already used as hunting companions by the ancient Egyptians. However, other predators of the savanna are a great threat to the cheetah. Since its body structure is primarily made for high speeds, a cheetah cannot protect itself sufficiently against a hyena or a lion. Therefore, cheetahs hunt exclusively during the day, when few other predators are active. This way, they simply avoid their dangerous rivals. Because cheetahs cannot protect their offspring sufficiently, the young ones stay in the den for up to 8 weeks after being born. Due to being hunted by humans for their fur, cheetahs are now an endangered species. The leopard is a feared predator in many parts of the world because among the large cats, it has the largest area of dispersal. With a grown weight of 1.5 tons and a height of up to 1.5 meters, rhinoceroses are the second largest terrestrial animals after the elephants. But as heavy and sluggish as they might seem, the rhinoceros is a true athlete. It can walk on almost every terrain effortlessly and reaches top speeds of up to 50 kilometers per hour. What makes a rhinoceros seem heavy is its thick skin. It looks like an armor and has this very function. It protects the rhinoceros from thorns and attacks. Nevertheless, the rhinoceros is not a fighter. Most confrontations between two animals are mere acts of intimidation as they run towards each other and avoid a crash in the very last moment. The rhinoceros can keep most other animals at a distance as well. Who would dare to attack an animal with a sharp weapon on its nose? The horn consists of a sticky mass that's excreted by the surrounding tissue. That's why it can regrow after being ripped off in combat. And the horn can cause considerable damage, despite not having a solid core. Unfortunately, the horn has always been a prized possession, which is why there are only 5 kinds of rhinoceroses left in the world, and they're all endangered. A spring turns into a trickle. The trickle transforms into a creek, and the creek develops into a river. The river drives its branches through the land, always pushing towards the sea. And every river impresses in its own unique way. As the blue veins of Earth, rivers flow across our entire planet. Their fresh water makes them givers of life that carry their springs into many different environments. They make it possible for plants and trees to grow, and thereby create conditions in which the birth of new life is possible. The river is a rich biotope that is home to an abundance of life we might not even expect. Be it at its shores, in its water, underneath its rocks, sticking to its plants, or buried in its sediment. On our journey along the river, we meet an astonishing biodiversity. Water and land share an inevitable bond. The water gives life to the land by supplying it through its life-saving hose all the way to the farthest corners of the earth. That's why rivers are a metaphor for the evolution of life itself. Born in the water, it conquered the earth to its very last corner. Today, our planet is a splendid proof for the triumph of life. Naturalist Charles Darwin developed his theory of adjustment through variation and natural selection in the year 1838. All over the world, we find clues that prove his theory to be correct. No matter how hard the conditions, be it underwater, in the air, or on land, life always finds a way. This way, the most successful survival strategies could prevail. In the highest heights, as well as in the deepest depths. In the lush grasslands and the dry steppes. With its individual characteristics, evolution set its milestones for every species. They can be exceptionally large, extremely heavy, or very strong. Others are especially cunning and intelligent. Among the most intelligent animals are the apes. And as their outer appearance, their movements, and their habits suggest, they are the direct ancestors of us, the humans. The success that makes our species the most productive on Earth comes from our coherence. We should never forget this, as well as the fact that nature is a part of us. We should wear the crown we gained in the course of thousands of years with dignity, the crown of creation.